How's everybody doing tonight? Welcome to the Jazz Combo Night here at CSUSB. My name is Christopher Sven. I'm the director of the Jazz Combos. We have a couple groups for you tonight. This first group is a first for us. This instrumentation is what I'm calling on the program, as you can see, a gypsy combo. And they're not actually gypsies, so sorry about that. It's a style of jazz that was made famous by a legendary virtuoso guitarist by the name of Django Reinhardt. He kind of started this following in like the 1930s, and most people think he's from France, but he's actually Belgian. But he played a lot in Paris and in France and had a group. But the instrumentation of gypsy jazz, it was going along on the same time. I think I'm really loud. I'm gonna back up a bit here. Is that better? Yeah? Okay, sorry about that. but anyways, there were big bands happening at the same time, like in the 30s. So the music was this boisterous kind of genre, but it was also in these small clubs in Paris and in the form of what we call gypsy jazz. A lot of times they didn't have a drum set. It was just like kind of a band of traveling gypsies. They had guitars. Those were easy to carry around. But they also had some other instruments that you don't typically see in jazz nowadays. One of them being the violin, and then another one being the clarinet. You see sometimes people double on clarinet, but not as frequently as you would see it in gypsy jazz. So first day of the quarter, this quarter, some violins show up, a clarinet shows up, a trumpet. It was a no-brainer. I made a gypsy combo. This is our first time doing it. Hope you guys like it. I'm not going to talk. Typically, I talk in between all the songs, but I'm going to kind of chunk away on the guitar and to save some time because we got a lot of music to get through. I'm just going to talk now and then at the end of the set. So the first tune we're doing is one of my favorites. It's called Out of Nowhere. It's a cool tune written a long time ago. Gypsy jazz artists like Django recorded versions of it. Then we're going to go into a vocal tune, another old standard called All of Me. And then the third tune is Nuage, which is French for clouds. And that was a tune written by Django Reinhardt, who's kind of the godfather of gypsy jazz. And after that, we'll go into Beyond the Sea, which is maybe a song you guys recognize from Finding Nemo. Made a big hit there. But Bobby Dearin has a famous version of it. Bless you, down in the front. And then we're going to close out the set with a fast one called I Got Rhythm. And that is a very popular song form in jazz. We call it Rhythm Changes now because so many artists wrote new melodies over that chord structure. It's one of the most famous, just like a blues is to jazz. The rhythm changes are one of the most famous. But that was the origin, is George Gershwin's I Got Rhythm. So I hope you guys enjoy. Give it up before we start here to the CSUSB Gypsy Jazz Combo. I know I said I wouldn't talk. Sorry about that. There we go. That's too loud again. I know I said I wouldn't talk, but just want to remind you, feel free to clap after they take a solo on the song. I heard someone trying to do it, and then they got scared. Don't be scared. It's okay to clap. We won't get mad at you. We'll actually like that more than you guys being awkwardly silent. All right, so here's All of Me. Thank you. Give it up to the first ever CSUSB Gypsy Jazz Combo. Yeah. We have Juan Ibanez Sanchez on the violin. Austin Terry on violin also. We have Jordan on the clarinet. What's your last name? Jordan Robles. Sorry about that. Jordan and Austin, this is their first time in the CSUSB Jazz Combo, so give an extra big, warm round of applause. They crushed it. And then we have Jocelyn Esparza on the trumpet. Judith Nunez on the alto saxophone. Johnny Obermeyer on the bass back there. Connor Pennington on the guitar. And Manny Alfaro on the guitar. Once again, I'm Christopher Sven, director of the Jazz Combo. Give us a few moments, a small intermission to rearrange the stage here. We gotta completely rework things. And we'll bring up what I'm calling the Friday Vibes Combo, so you won't wanna miss that. All right, thank you guys. Snap, crackle, pop. So this group behind me, some of these guys have been in this for quite a bit. This is, I would call them the veterans, if you will. We've got Nate Wallace on the drum kit. Give it up for Nate. Francisco Aguilar on the vibes. This is your first one on vibes, right? Yeah, this is his first time playing vibes in one of these combos. Usually he's our drummer in the combos, but he switched it up this quarter. He told Nate, he said, "Hey man, you gotta play drum set because I wanna play vibes." Nate followed through. He's got his back. And we got Mark Garcia on the trumpet and flugel, I just found out. Welcome back, Joni Obermeyer on the bass. Yeah. This is standing up, Joni. We were all sitting down. It's a different vibe for this one. This is why we're the vibes combo. We've got Sean Monsalve on the guitar. And also welcome back, Connor Pennington, but this time on electric guitar. Yeah. So we're going to start this setup with a Benny Golson tune. Benny Golson was a famous tenor saxophone player. He kind of rubbed shoulders with Coltrane. But his tunes are notoriously hard, and they're a good one to kind of to study and learn how to play over. This is a cool arrangement that we took from an Art Farmer album. It was with Jim Hall on guitar, and I believe Gary Burton on vibes. It was kind of the same instrumentation that we have, so that's why we chose that arrangement. But typically this has a swing feel, where the ride, that type of thing. But in this version, they kind of made it a little bit more funky. So I hope you like it. This is Benny Golson's Whisper Not. Thank you. Yeah, give it up. Friday Night Vibes combo. So this next tune is, this is a tough one. This one's called Nika's Dream. And this one is written, it's a dedication, it's written by Horace Silver, who was an amazing jazz pianist. But it was dedicated to this woman who was a baroness that was from Europe, I forget which country, but then she moved to New York. And a lot of the great jazz legends wrote kind of dedications to her because she really looked after them. This was a time during segregation and racism was running rampant through the United States. And it was hard for a lot of the African-American jazz artists to get to their gigs every day. They couldn't get a taxi. It was just hard getting around town. But she was always nice enough to lend her limousine. And so these guys that couldn't even catch a taxi were showing up to gigs in limos because of this baroness. So a lot of people dedicated pieces to her. This is one of them, Nika's Dream. There's also a Thelonious Monk song called Panonica, which was her full name. This one has a lot of different movements in it. The first section has kind of a Latin vibe, Afro-Cuban, if you will. And then it goes into a different contrasting feel for the bridge. So listen for those. This is Horace Silver's Nika's Dream. Thank you. So next, we're going to slow things down a bit. This is a beautiful ballad that goes by the title Polka Dots and Moonbeams. Hope you guys like it. So the next tune we're going to play for you is a composition by the legendary jazz pianist Bud Powell, and hence the name Bouncing with Bud. He's kind of a tragic character within jazz, like a genius. But he had an altercation in a bar and like got hit over the head pretty severely, I believe by like a security guard or something like that. They claim it was racism. But then he was taken to like a mental facility, and they did like electroshocking treatment of him at the time when they were experimenting with that in the United States. And Miles Davis claims that he wasn't ever the same after he did that, but his career continued. So I always think of that when I hear Bud Powell's music, because he's such a genius, and he would face so much adversity because of racism. But he's a good artist that doesn't get as much of a, people don't know him as well as like the Bill Evans or even like the Thelonious Monk. But Bud Powell's one of the greatest, and so I recommend checking him out. He's one of those guys that hummed along when he played, so some of the recordings, don't let that distract you. Try to listen to the notes. I really like this next tune. It's one of my favorites of his. So, hope you enjoy. This is Bouncing with Bud. Thank you. Thank you guys for coming this early in the quarter to come check out the jazz combo night here at CSUSB. Give a round of applause for you guys. Thank you. It means a lot to us. I never know if we're even going to get any people this early, but it kind of snuck up on us, as the concerts usually do. But we're going to close out the set here with one of my favorite tunes to play. And this comes from one of my favorite albums, one of those kind of just all-star records, called Like Minds, which features Chick Corea on piano, Pat Metheny on guitar, Gary Burton on the vibraphone, Roy Haynes on the drum set, and blanking on the bass player's name. Sorry, Bill. Bill's staring right at me. Got a bass player right in front of me. It'll come to me. I'll get back to you on that one. He's the guy that plays on... He had his own free jazz group, kind of. No. Dang. It's like at the tip of my tongue. Anyways, I'll get back to you on that one. So that it's just one of those albums, like just all stars. They all had pretty happening careers on in their own right, and then they decided to get together and make this classic album. This is a tune written by the piano player Chick Corea on that album. He had recorded it previously, but this version is kind of the go-to version for this song, in my opinion. So hope you like it. It's gonna close it out with a bang, literally, from our glorious drummer, Nate Wallace, over here. Give it up. Yeah. So this is Windows by Chick Corea. Give it up one more time. Connor Pennington on the guitar. Sean Monsalve on the guitar. Johnny Obermeyer on the bass guitar. Mark Garcia on the flugel and trumpet. Got Francisco Aguilar on the vibraphone. And Nate Wallace crushing the drum set over there. Thanks again for coming to the Jazz Combo Night here. Hope to see you next quarter. And then after that, the next semester, I guess. Looking forward to that. Some quarters with a group, it sneaks up on you. We're looking forward to semesters. Actually get something done. Oh. No, I didn't mean that against you guys. And by the way, it was Dave Holland. That was the bass player. I couldn't remember. There we go. Remembered. All right, have a safe drive home, you guys. See you next time.